Hi, I'm Jordan, and as you might hear from the accent, I'm French. And here's my story. Last year, my girlfriend, our cat, and I left everything behind to go full-time overlanding.
There we go.
Here we go. Guys, we're leaving. Finally.
And we had a blast. North through Norway, crossed the Arctic Circle, and reached the northernmost point of Europe, the North Cap. Headed south through Finland, and I gotta tell you, I felt in love with Lapland. Nevertheless, we had to keep going on the journey, and it didn't take long to enter the Baltic states, three countries that deserve way more attention. They are stunning, especially during the fall season with those warm colors. And after a few months, we ended up in Spain, a mind-blowing country where you can be in the mountains, in the deserts, and at the sea coast within a few hours.
That was an awesome trip, right? But actually, it was supposed to be only the beginning for us. Because for 2020, we planned an 8-month long trip going through Russia, Central Asia, and Mongolia. The adventure of a lifetime. But you probably heard about it. Something called COVID-19 happened. And just like that, all the borders were closed. And the adventure we dreamed of and prepared for 2 years was gone. I was devastated at first. But quickly, I started to tell myself that I should make the most out of this situation. And my home country, France, is beautiful. So let's explore it.
Forester was ready to go, so we directly went for some adventures as soon as the quarantine was over. It was a bit sketchy sometimes, but always fun and smart. The countryside, but also went into the mountains. Relaxed and chilled at camp, surrounded by beautiful landscapes.
So what I've learned with all of that is, even if the situation might look bad, you can't just stop. What you want to do is to always work on that situation to make the best of it. So maybe 2020 wasn't the best year for overlanding, but 2021 can be worse. Mongolia, we didn't forget about you.